Alright, tonight we saw Venom, Let There Be Carnage, the newest Sony Spider-Man spin-off film. Connor, what's the plot of Let There Be Carnage?
Let There Be Carnage is a two-act movie where Eddie Brock is a reporter on the low who gets an interview with serial killer Cletus Cassidy. And at the interview, Cletus Cassidy bites him, causing Cletus Cassidy to get some of his blood and become Carnage. Then he saves his girlfriend and kidnaps Eddie's ex-girlfriend. And Eddie says, "I have to save her." Then they fight in a church. The end. This will be a spoiler review, by the way. I don't think any of that was much of a spoiler. We're going to spoil the end credits, probably, because it's the most interesting thing in this entire movie. So, Aiden, what did you think of Let There Be Carnage?
Honestly, Let There Be Carnage is a much better movie than the first, but it's still pretty bad. To be nice to the movie for a second, I think the Venom-Eddie dynamic works a little better. Someone told Tom Hardy to tone down the accent he was using in the last movie. He's gone from squeaky Brooklyn man to less squeaky Brooklyn man. The CGI's better. And then there's everything else. So the biggest thing you might notice is that this movie doesn't have a story. It's kind of like, they kind of try to do like a breakup story with Venom and Eddie, which I'm pretty sure they did in the last one too, kind of.
Yeah.
And, yeah, there's an intro to the movie where they meet the serial killer guy, and then he gets sentenced to death and becomes Carnage, and that's like the first 15 minutes of the movie. And then they break up and they do things separately for a while, and then they fight Carnage. It's like, it's not so much that there's not a second act as that there's no first act. There's 10 minutes of setup, and then the second act and the third act.
Eddie has nothing to do because it's just him and Venom. And there's only so much you can sustain off of that, so it's...
Yeah. Well,
it's a two-act movie.
The villain is just doing his own stuff for a while. Like, we spend more time with the villain in the first... In the middle of the movie where Eddie and Venom are separated. Venom's just... hanging around at a gay bar talking about coming out of the closet.
Cut from the final release, but I swear it, when I watched it the first time in a way that I can't talk about when I saw it the first time, but Venom says, "I'm coming out of the Eddie closet." He says, "I'm coming out of the Eddie closet."
Yeah.
And that was cut. Anyway. I swear on my life.
They have their big separation. During the separation, Eddie sits around in his apartment and kicks rocks, and he just has nothing to do, and they don't meet the villain until, like, the second they start fighting him. I mean, besides, like, at the start when he gets infected with the symbiote.
Right.
And then he's just separate, and there's a completely separate movie that goes down for a while where it's just Carnage running around killing people and freeing his girlfriend.
It's not even separate, they just don't know what to do with the protagonist.
Yeah, the protagonist has nothing to do. He doesn't know where the villain is, he doesn't have anything to do, he knows who the villain is, so there's nothing to investigate.
Politely invites him to the final battle, the final confrontation, like, Eddie has nothing to do in the whole movie.
No, I mean, yeah, he has nothing to do for 90% of the movie. He does one thing at the start, and then he does... the fight at the end. So it's a mess structurally. Just like the entire plot structure of the movie's fucked. And that really alone is enough to kind of completely shit up the movie. The action is better-ish than the first one. There's a little more going on than whatever the fuck happened at the end of the first one where they're like hanging off a rocket or...
whatever.
Something. I think another fundamental problem with the Venom movies is that, especially in this one, Venom's just like a superhero who occasionally eats people. He's not really a bad guy at all. No, not really. A very nice guy who just occasionally eats people because that's how he survives.
Yeah.
He wants to be a superhero. He wants to be a superhero more than Eddie Brock does. Eddie Brock complains all the time about not wanting to do anything and being a lazy bitch. And Venom's like, let's go be superheroes. But I also need to occasionally eat people's heads.
Right.
It's like, it's so fucking weird. You'd think these Venom movies would be fucking edge fests, and the first one kind of was, but this one's just like completely toothless. That's just another weird thing about it. I don't know. Overall, it's more tolerable than the first one, but not by a whole lot, I guess. It's certainly better made, slightly better written. I guess the Venom-Eddie dynamic kind of works. I noticed that Andy Serkis, who directed this, really wanted to go for the fucking cornball shots with, like, Carnage in front of the stained glass window. There's a little, I don't know why it veered into that direction in the end, or he's trying to do all, like, these really epic trailer shots that are still left in the movie. Yeah, I mean, I want to say Venom 2 is the worst thing I've ever seen, but it's really just very mediocre and clumsy, I guess is the best word. So, Connor, what'd you think of Let There Be Carnage?
Venom 2 is far worse than the first movie. I have no idea what you're talking about.
Absolutely not.
The first movie has a plot because Eddie Brock has something to do.
Yeah,
the villain story is a lot worse. But that's because this entire movie is the villain story and they have no idea what to do with the protagonist.
Yeah.
But the first one's an actual movie. Like, there's a conventional three-act structure. There's a screenplay. Riz Ahmed is the villain.
Venom 2 is an experimental art film, you don't understand.
Venom 2 is an incomplete picture.
Yes.
It's an incomplete film. They didn't know what to do with the main character because there's no motivation for Eddie Brock. He's pretty loose on having anything he wants to do. He loves Anne still, and Anne appears slightly in the movie here and there, but there's not enough there to add drama without just retreading the last movie, and they're kind of beyond the romance.
Yeah, even without a plot, they still kind of retreaded everything, and they also...
Right.
I don't know why these movies insist on making it look like Tom Hardy hasn't showered in 2 weeks.
Yeah.
He's always, like, sticky and greasy, and his hair's all, like, matted up. It's funny.
Yeah.
What are they thinking?
And then, on top of that, I mean, like you said, it's a two-act story. Like I was saying, it's a two-act story. I've seen this movie twice now, and I've hated it both times. I liked it slightly more this time. Like, I was at least I knew what I was getting into, which was a fight scene. And the fight scene is creative, and the CGI is better than most of what's coming out of Marvel, which is kind of surprising.
Yeah.
I don't know where Sony gets their CG teams that they're actually decent.
Well, the CG in Venom 1 sucked. I don't know. It's just, like, completely turned around for this one.
No, but I mean, like, Sony used to have, like, some cutting-edge CG, and they can occasionally have really good movies like Blade Runner, which are CG-heavy. Blade Runner 2049.
Yeah.
So, but it looks a lot better than, like, Black Panther, Shang-Chi, or something like that.
Black Widow.
Black Widow.
Yeah.
Like, that final fight scene when the bell is ringing was really good. Like, there was actually some...
Yeah, that was some really creative.
The final fight scene was actually a really good fight scene. Like, I feel like Andy Serkis's CGI strengths work in this movie well. He knows what to do with these CG characters to make it exciting and interesting.
The fight scene...
But he doesn't know how to write, like, dialogue, or he doesn't know how to have, like, direct a movie with, like, character motivation or dialogue. I mean, that's also on the screenplay, but...
Yeah.
And the editing, there's a lot of issues with the film.
The fight scene was about the most creative thing you could do with a Venom fight scene.
I mean, you look at, like, what Sony and Pascal Pictures put together, and their priorities were clearly fight scene for this movie. Why else would you hire a CGI man? Why would you hire Gollum from The Lord of the Rings and King Kong if you're gonna fucking...
Someone said, what if we had two Venoms fight while the bell kept ringing and...
And they were in a big church.
Making them go back and forth, and it's a big church of stained glass.
See, I thought the shit with, like, Riz Ahmed and stuff, the journey of the first movie, was slightly better, and there was some drama with Eddie there. It was still pretty bad, but it, I thought the first Venom was fine. This movie's a travesty, but it has good fights. But, like, you know, I don't think they know what to do with Eddie Brock. He's a vehicle to get yelled at by Venom. Like, Venom's much more of a character than Eddie Brock. And that's kind of a problem when Eddie Brock is supposed to ground your movie. That's your whole point. And he doesn't have a motivation like revenge against Spider-Man. He doesn't really have hatred towards Cletus Kasady. The only reason he's upset is because Cletus Kasady broke out and might want to kill him. And then Cletus Kasady wants to kill Venom, which is the only reason Eddie ever goes after him. And the only reason Cletus Kasady captures Anne is because he has a picture of Anne in his house. So it's like, ultimately, Eddie's totally motivationless in this movie. He doesn't he's very passive about trying to get Venom back until he needs Venom to break out of jail.
Eddie might be the greatest cape shit protagonist ever made. Hear me out.
He has absolutely no
A protagonist is supposed to be an audience surrogate. What are the traits that Eddie Brock has? Greasy. Stinky, greasy, okay. Loser, no girlfriend. His only friend is a creepy alien that lives in his head and breaks all his shit. He's a surrogate for the cape shit fans.
Didn't think about it that way.
He's perfectly
designed. But he drives around on his blaze red Ducati, which is too chadly for any cape shit lover.
Yeah, he's also fucking ripped, but...
Yeah. But I mean, he's a surrogate.
Yeah.
So you get some of the traits. All I can really say on the positive are the fights are cool, and what I can say on the negative is there's no motivation. I don't think Cletus Kasady's a very good villain.
Yep.
I think the acting's poor in the movie, especially from Tom Hardy and Woody Harrelson.
Yep.
I don't find Venom's shtick enjoyable. I think Venom's cool when he's fighting Carnage. I think some of the CGI is cool. So, I think the priority Sony had, which was give a fight for the brain dead, something to entertain the brain dead for a few minutes, was was good. But in terms of actual, like, anything else, I think the movie's pretty fucking terrible. So, Aiden, shall we talk about how Sony scammed their way into the MCU? With the post-credit scene of this movie?
Yeah.
So I want to point out that I was right. I had a lot of time on my hands when I briefly lived in Las Vegas, and I watched all the interviews for Venom, and I noticed that Amy Pascal would actively harass Kevin Feige saying that Venom was in the MCU in a certain type of way. And it would be vehemently denied. So I always considered Venom part of the MCU, kind of as a meme, but also kind of because I knew it would happen eventually, especially when that Spider-Man stuff went down. Yep. And then when Morbius' trailer came out with Michael Keaton, it was confirmed a little more. But here we have 100% Tom Holland / Venom sharing the silver screen.
They did it.
In the after-credits scene.
In the post-credits scene, the dimensional merge from Spider-Man No Way Home, presumably,
or
happens.
Something.
And Eddie Brock ends up in what's presumably an alternate universe and sees Tom Holland Spider-Man on the TV, which means Sony finally did it. They accomplished their goal. They held Spider-Man hostage, they got more money, and they shoved their shitty Venom movies into the MCU.
Yep.
A little bit of a spoiler for Spider-Man No Way Home, but we will be seeing Venom in that, presumably.
I don't know if he'll show up in No Way Home, or if this is an excuse for Spider-Man to show up in later movies.
I think it's going to be No Way Home. I think it's both. It'll be both. But I'm saying, I think No Way Home is almost a definite... Because they put him... No Way Home starts... immediately after Homecoming. Wait, what was the last one?
Far From Home.
Yeah. The new one takes place immediately after the last one, and Eddie gets warped in right as Spider-Man gets revealed in the last one. There's no way this isn't some No Way Home bullshit. We're gonna have to deal with Venom for the rest of time.
Yeah, but the thing is, it revealed on the TV that he's still Spider-Man. The whole plot of No Way Home is that he's not gonna be there. Who knows? I guess we'll figure out pretty soon, but Tom Holland, Venom, eventual crossover, pretty much confirmed.
Yep. Venom's so, in the MCU now. Sony did it.
It's canonically at least an alternate universe of the MCU, or alternate timeline.
Something.
So they're together now. There you go.
Yep.
So, Sony, congratulations. The big scam finally worked out for you.
The long con.
The long con. You guys screwed Disney into forcing your way into their shared continuity in a quest to make more money. And you succeeded, so nice job.
Yeah, this shit's just gonna guarantee we get like 8 more Venom movies.
Good job. I'm happy with it, whatever. I mean, this Venom was bad. The first Venom was bad in its own unique way.
Aren't they kind of just like out of characters for Venom to fight that's not Spider-Man?
Basically, he fought
Black Venom. He fought other Black Venom.
Just make
Venom
fight
Venom.
Other Spider-Man villains. You can literally put in whatever character. They can do whatever they want with Spider-Man, really. They could put...
Oh, God, I just realized that fucking Jamie Foxx Electro is going to be in the new movie. I forgot that.
Anyways, Aiden, would you recommend...
No, I don't recommend Venom. Let There Be Carnage. It's not worth it.
I watched this movie twice, so you don't have to.
Connor, would you recommend Venom? Let There Be Carnage.
I watched this movie twice, so you don't have to. That was how I put it subtly, that I watched Venom 2 twice, and it's a shitty-ass movie. I wouldn't watch it.
But also, I'm really disappointed that the Venom 2 rap is not nearly as funny as the Venom 1 rap. Thank you. Venom, I got that.